Now, it is a sad fact that bullying is rife in our schools and that some children will never recover from it. It's a problem that became all too real this week for one of our producers who was organising his school reunion. I'm going to read you now the email that he received from a classmate. Have a look. Hi, Grant. This is a blast from the past. I don't think we've spoken since the formal, and I wanted to write to you for a couple of reasons. The first is to let you know that, unfortunately, I won't be attending the reunion. High school was a pretty traumatic experience for me. Every day I would wake up dreading the fact that I would have to go to school and face the likes of... that name is actually laid blank, who would tease and taunt me every day, every single minute of every single day until that 3:20 bell rang. This bullying happened from day one of grade seven right through to formal. I don't think...
That person.
..knew how much of an impact his comments would have on me, but it has taken a long time to feel any self-worth or any belief that I deserve to be here and to enjoy my life. For years after school, I struggled. I thought of taking my life. I considered disappearing and trying to forge a new identity, but realistically, I knew that I would never be able to follow through with any of those things. I struggled to go to university and I failed to make friends because I felt like I was worthless. His taunts had such an impact on me that I even struggled to get a job. I became a social recluse and even developed a drinking problem. All my confidence was shattered by him. It wasn't until about a year and a half ago that I decided to reach out and get some help. I have slowly turned the ship around and now I am sober, I have friends and a great career. I still have a long way to go, but I know I am on my way. You might be wondering, why is this guy telling me all of this? The reason is to say thank you, because you were always there for me. You always said hello. You weren't disappointed when you would walk into English and find that the only seat that was left in the room was next to me. You stood up for me on many occasions and would talk to me in the canteen line and ignore the sniggers and comments that were being thrown my way. I'm always going to be thankful and I wanted you to know that. I also was hoping that you can use this experience as motivation to shed light on the issue of bullying through your role in the media. You have a voice which can help those like me see that there is help out there, and those people, like unnamed again, to see that your words can have major consequences long after the 3:20 bell rings. And Grant, our producer, joins us on the panel now. Gee, it's a powerful...
Good on you, Grant.
Yeah. A really powerful email that you received.
Yeah, I was pretty gutted when I got it, actually, because I knew this guy had struggled through school and I knew that he suffered a lot. But I guess I didn't realise the extent after high school, because we haven't had contact in years, in which he'd struggled. So it was quite surprising that the name-calling and stuff had such an impact on his
life. Did you know he was being bullied at school?
Yeah, it was very well known to everyone that he was bullied at school. I remember there was one day in class he actually was getting clumps of paper thrown at him and that sort of stuff in the back of the head. And that was actually in year 12. So this
And how old are you, Grant? When did you graduate?
I'm 27, so I graduated 2005.
So this stayed with him for 10 years.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, exactly.
But it's so nice that the little things you did made such a difference too. That the fact that he remembers your kindness and the way you react, that's a really positive message out of this too, I think.
Yeah. Yeah. I guess I didn't really think about it at the time. It was just sort of like, you know, you feel sorry for him, but it wasn't, you know, you're not going to jump on the bandwagon. I don't think many people would jump on a bandwagon like that. Mm.
But you are just naturally a very kind and decent person, and everyone here knows that. It is so hard, though, and the insidious nature of bullying, and I'm bet London to a brick this is what happened with your friend, where people see it happening, they know it's happening, and, of course, everyone is terrified to step in and intervene because then, of course, the bully would turn on them and that's what they're scared of.
Yeah.
And I'm guessing, did anyone take any action or take it to teachers or the principal?
And this isn't anything against my school. The school was great. But, you know, how can bullying go undetected for 5 years without some sort of consequences? And from... You know, my memory, it was always the same guy who would do it. But at this point, it's probably...
So there were no consequences then?
Not that I recall.
What would you say to him now, that bully? things I want to ask you. Is the unnamed bully going to the reunion?
He will be there. Yeah, I know that
he is. What's he doing? Oh, well, that's what I want to know. Where is the unnamed bully now, and how's his life progressed?
I think he's doing quite well for himself in terms. Like, I think he still lives in the hometown and that sort of stuff.
But what would you say to him?
I would just say, it's hard because I don't think he's that same person anymore.
But we'll still. Why what would you say
him,
to him?
Why don't you show him the letter?
Because I don't feel like he should be held accountable for. You know, if that was me and it was 10 years ago... Yeah.
Because basically you're turning the world onto him and thinking, you know, we then become the bullies.
Yeah.
I mean, for something he did 10 years
back
ago.
In the day,
and obviously it's horrible. Let's not be, you know, let's not mince our words. But we can't then all jump on this guy and then bully him into...
And I'm sure others jumped on the bandwagon too.
Like, but I'm not saying jump on him, but I'm just thinking it's the same kind of issue that... No one had the courage at the time to stand up to this particular person. And I think this particular person needs to know the consequences that he has wrought with his behaviour.
I think this person has definitely seen the email and I think he knows that it is him. But it is also, I think, valid to point out that this guy I know went through a massive tragedy when he was a child without giving away too much. But he went through a lot. So to turn around 10 years later and say, well, you've ruined someone's life 10 years ago, I don't think that's fair on him either.
I'm not saying that he ruined his life, but I do think people need to be made aware of the consequences of what their behaviour can do.
Right. People do. I mean, obviously, when you're a kid, you know, we make exceptions because you're not a fully formed human being. But people do still need to be held to account for their actions, however much they might be mitigated by their youth. But the other problem is, of course, that when you're the bully, you don't actually realise the impact it's having on the victim. Like, I would be sure that whoever did it would have sort of thought no more about it. They probably thought it was just a few youthful hijinks and they were just mucking around, and that's what boys do.
Maybe it's the school that needs to know the consequences of this action.
Yeah.
Because I can't believe a teacher didn't know that the boy was being bullied all the time. I think it's the school that needs to see the letter. And because it reinforces why you've got to be on alert for a boy who is being bullied and the boy who is the bully.
Absolutely. It's just very difficult because bullying takes place either almost sort of hidden in plain sight.
Yeah.
It's a very intimate relationship.
You've got to think, unless this bloke is an absolute psychopath and sociopath who's grown up to become a serial killer in his spare time, I think reading... I mean, any human being reads this letter and just... thinks, oh my gosh, oh my gosh.
The worst part about
it's almost like kids in high school need to read this and just sort of say, look, you need to think twice before you pick on someone.
You say something. Once I put this online, and I didn't know how much of an impact it would sort of have, and people started sharing it, I've been sent so many messages, even on the Studio 10 Facebook page where it's been posted as well. So many people have commented on there. One man, I think, was in his 50s and actually said, you know, I'm still struggling from bullying. So it just shows how widespread it sort of is.
And the sad reality is that it doesn't stop at high school. It happens in the workplace.
Yeah.
It happens in mothers' groups. It happens everywhere in the world. So
On this show too, Ida was in the dressing room really giving me heaps of...
Well, you're the sort of bloke that needs heaps.
You know, but, you know, we need to give our kids the right tools to be able to deal with it.
But
because
Grant did say something quite significant. You said we all knew the boy was being bullied.
Yes, we did.
We all knew.
It was no secret in the school that this guy didn't have any friends and that every day he was sort of being picked on for the stupidest things, the colour of his hair, his weight, that sort of thing. And the thing is, you know, I got to know him a little bit and he was genuinely a really nice guy that just liked reading and wasn't into sport or anything like that. So.
Well, I think it's a really positive thing that you've done by getting this email out there. I hope more people read it. Grant, thank you for that.
Thanks.
You can read the letter in full, except we've obviously left out some identities. We've posted that letter on our Facebook page. Have a read of it. Let us know what you think.